Welcome to Monday Night Rollins. Drew, I'm sorry, I didn't even see you there. I was too busy, soaking up the spotlight, right?
All right, here we go.
Here we go what, Drew?
I know you've got more. Get it all out of your system, please.
No, no, no.
I'll just hang out in the background. Enjoy the spotlight, because after WrestleMania, the spotlight's all mine.
Hey, look. I came out here with an honest cause, Drew. I don't like you. I think you're stupid. I think you're a hypocrite. I think you said a lot of dumb things in the last few weeks. But I came out here to admit one thing you said is absolutely correct, and I wanted to admit it to your face. I wanted to do it right here in Raleigh in front of all these fine folks. Now, they always say the first step on the road to recovery is the hardest, so if you'll bear with me, please. I've been working on this. It's going to be difficult for me, but... My name is Seth freaking Rollins. And I'm a spotlight junkie.
Everything's just a joke to you, isn't it, mate? Look at you. You're becoming a parody of yourself at this point. But honestly, I just don't care about the BS anymore, Seth. I've tried to reason with you. I've gave the answers. At this point, I literally only care about our match and the world title. And you want to know the punchline, funny man? Well, you guys, you know every time you say what, it means you're happy I took out CM Punk. Thanks for remembering. The punchline, funny man, is when I beat you for that title at WrestleMania. Let's not be ridiculous. Punk will be here next week. He would never show up in somewhere like Raleigh. You hear that, Punk? They're booing you, but it's true. You're going to leave your couch in Chicago to justify
hey,
that
Drew,
big contract.
Shut your trap!
I see I got your attention.
Yeah, you got my attention, all right, you know, because this isn't a joke to me. When I said I was an addict, when I said I was a spotlight junkie, it wasn't a joke to me. You see, I've been doing this for 20 years, Drew. 20 years! Just like you. And every single time I come out of that curtain, that's my fix, man. And it gets better and better and better every single time. When I come out here, I lay it all on the line in this ring. It gets better and better every single time. When I hear these people sing my song so loud I can barely speak, that's my fix, Drew. That's the spotlight I crave. And you know what? I want the spotlight as bright as it can possibly be. So look, I know you've been busy online trying to entertain the people on Twitter, making memes. You haven't really been listening to what I've been telling you. So let me get this through your thick skull. Night one of WrestleMania. I take the biggest star in Hollywood and his side chick, and I make them my bitches. And then night two, the biggest spotlight possible will be shined down on you and me and the World Heavyweight Championship.
I guess all hail our savior, Seth Rollins. Thank you very much. You had me. And that's what I want. I want that passion. I don't want the stupid outfits. I don't want the laughing. I don't want the dancing. I want the passion. You had me all the way to the finish. You've done this for 20 years, just like I've done this for 20 years. We've gave our life to this industry, and that's what you've made this title all about. The wrestler's title, the real wrestler's title, the workhorse championship. You had me until you mentioned the big spotlight. And the reason we're going to get it is because you're going to pin one of the biggest stars in the world. Why can't it just be because of all your hard work to make that title and all of my hard work to get to this point? Why can't that be the reason we're getting the biggest spotlight? Your priorities are all wrong, man. You got it backwards. I've been giving you the answers, and I told you I honestly don't care about all the BS now. All I care about is you make it to the ring a night to a WrestleMania, and if you can't walk, we'll wheel you down. If they can't wheel you down, I will carry you down, because at WrestleMania, I'm not going to get the moment I deserve. I am going to get the moment I have bloody earned.
Ah, Drew. There it is. That's right. You want to call me a spotlight junkie, but you want the spotlight just as bad as I do, don't you? You're an addict just like I am. And you've been begging for spotlight for the past 4 years because you won the WrestleMania main event. You did, back in 2020, in an empty warehouse. And all we've been hearing from Drew McIntyre for the past 4 years was how that wasn't good enough. You've been whining and complaining and bitching and moaning that you deserve better, that you deserve more. The problem is, Drew, when everybody came back around and the lights got bright again, what happened? You fumbled the ball. And that's the difference between you and me. When the lights are the brightest, I shine, baby. I shine bright. And at WrestleMania 40, the lights are going to be as bright as they have ever been. And you are going to find out you're not as good as you think you are.
The games continue. 19
nights. You don't like me, but you can't hang with me, son. Listen to him! Listen!